H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
So now we'll execute this. I mean, we'll capture a group of UI objects and then we'll try to write them into a notepad. Okay, so basically we are going to understand this section. So I'm going to use the same thing. Okay, so see here, I'm copying the same method here. So this particular method basically for displaying on the console. Okay. So now I just copied the same method and let me name it as write to notepad. Okay. So here instead of displaying on the console, we will try to write into notepad. Okay. So here very simple, there are two simple things. Now see here I'm first of all I'm creating a file here. Okay, first of all by logic I'm trying to create a file. If you want to create a file, see here, create a empty file. First of all, if you want to in general also if you want to write if you want to have a notepad, first of all we have to create a notepad and then we have to write content, right? So here, everyone agree here. So this is the syntax. File, you can give the name of the file. I'm just using the creating the syntax here. File, let me say, input file, new file. Yep. So this is the syntax for creating a file. But here, I'm passing a parameter here. If I pass a parameter in this instance, what it is called as, technically we are passing a parameter here. So here internally there is something called constructor, right? Let me complete it. Say I want to create a file here, I want to save under this particular folder. Okay, so now everyone agree here we have to give the name of the file. When I say name of the file, we have to give the complete path of the file too. Okay, so let me say eBay prices dot txt. Okay, now if you all agree here, eBay prices. Now if you go and agree here we don't have any file with eBay prices. Okay, yes, there is the eBay, there is something, but there is no file with eBay prices. Okay, so this particular file will be going to create from this program. Okay, and if you have a path, what we have to do here, I hope I explained this. If we have a path in a Java logic, what we have to do, did you remember? They have to mention double slash. I think we have discussed this during the multiple browsers where we were pointing to the browser instances, I mean browser drivers. Now see here. Here use import the java.io. java.io means it is again inbuilt of Java files. Okay. Now basically this line is going to create a new text file. This one eBay prices.txt file will be going to be it is going to be created. Okay, by this line. So which is nothing but creating instance, and basically it is a creating instance with a constructor. Right? Did you remember this one? Yep, this way. No, actually I have used this one, second way of creating instance. Okay. Class name, object name, new, a constructor. Did you remember the constructor? Did you remember? Yes or no? We discussed the concept called constructor in Java. Okay, if not, please refer. Please refer it. Okay. If say yes or no, I would have. I can directly go with the topic here. Otherwise, see here. If you remember, I said constructor means there will be a default constructor, and the constructor we can have a. We can create our own constructor. If you remember, I said, this is the name of the class, right? So here, by default, I said, it will be like this. I said public, and name of the there will be a method with the same name of the class. Did you remember this one? Are you able to recollect it? This is the default constructor. Apart from this, there can be a public name of the class, and here we can pass some parameters, string ABC, some parameters we can pass. Did you remember? I said this is the method. This is the method. This is a method with the name of the class, same name of the class. Okay. I said this is the constructor. While creating instance, basically you can pass a parameter here. Okay, say if I'm planning to create an instance of this group of objects, okay, here I can pass a parameter here. That is what actually we are doing. So we know normal way, right? It seems all of you forget this. I can see only two people are saying yes, but I don't see the other people. That's the reason I'm again trying to give an explanation here. See here, if there are three people, that's great. Public static void main string args. Now here if I want to create an instance, generally what we are doing, this one, group of objects, right? And I can say any instance. Okay, let me say obj1 new now see here, this is what we know. At least all of you know about this. Say yes or no, why you guys are not interactive. You know about this, right? How to create instance. Any questions on this highlighted one? Any questions on the highlighted one? No, right? It's clear, right? That is, we have been using this one. Actually, that is the problem. We have been using only this. We never come across this, the other way. Yep. Now, see here. I'm creating one more instance. See here, this is also creating instance, okay, but here I am passing a value. So how it is possible? So basically it is possible because if you observe here, Then we have see here, it is possible because of this. Here when we write this line, it is going to be refer this. Okay. When we write this this line, okay, which is going to refer, which is basically going to refer this one. And what it is.
Hello, Kumar.
Yes.
Kumar?
Yes.
Your audio is breaking.
Oh. What about others? Devon, others are saying it is good. Can you please check at your end?
Yeah, now it is okay.
Okay, yep. Now see here, when you use this line, basically internally it is going to refer this. Okay, this is nothing but constructor session. Okay, please refer the class transcript. Okay, and you even now please refer the as of now please refer the existing videos. Okay, we have discussed as part of Java class. Okay, now this is the actual implementation. Now onwards we are going to use this constructor. Okay, now onwards we are going to use this constructor concepts very frequently. Okay, so simple constructor means we'll have a method. Same name of the class. Okay, so here by default, even though you create this, even though you don't create it, it is going to be created by default in the background. I also said this is called as default constructor, and here this is a constructor that we have created. Here I want to pass one parameter here. Okay, and even here we can create the other constructor. See here. So, public okay, this is of the constructor. Okay, now see here, now I can create one more instance. Here while creating instance I can pass two parameters here, of course like this. Okay, did you are you able to recollect the concept? Did you remember this? This we have discussed as part of constructor, as part of Java. Okay. Now, at least now is it clear? Now, at least is this clear? Yep, great. Now we'll resume back to our topic. Where is this? Write to notepad. We'll come to this particular one. Okay. Now this is what we have done here. Okay. Here we have created instance. For this instance, we have passed a value here. Okay. We have passed a value to it. While creating the instance itself, we have passed a value. Even if you remember, this we already used here. Give a minute. Where we wrote this logic, handling different objects. EBSH. If you discuss here, handling different UI objects. If you remember, here we are creating instance, select, here we are passing a parameter here. Okay. If you remember, if you want to handle a list box, if you want to handle a drop down, we have to create a select instance, right? Here also we are passing a parameter. Okay. Same concept. Here we are creating instance. Here we are passing a locator basically. Okay. Here we are passing a value here. We are passing a part of the text file. Okay. However, by by this line it is going to create a text file. Okay. Now see here. There is something called print writer. See here, let me complete this, then let me explain. Now everyone agree here, I wrote something called print writer. Basically this instance is going to help us to write some content into the file. This line it will just create a text file. Okay, it will not help us in writing the content to it. If I want to write some content to a file, I have to use something called print writer. Okay, so by using this I can write some content to the file. Okay, now see here it is showing a red color underline, because here it is, there is a risk logic, because this is a basically a risk logic. Why this is a risk logic? Because we are handling with a file. So by chance, say this part is not there. See here I mentioned class H2K Infosys Selenium. So by some chance, say this part is not there. In that case, there is a probability that this file may not create, right? In that case, this particular print writer is going to get into a risky status. Okay, so that is the reason it is asking us to include an exception. Again, we have used exception. We understood exception session. Okay, now here actually see here we are throwing an exception saying that file not found exception. Okay, we can directly mention file not exception. Simply, we can mention exception. Okay, exception is something like higher level just. Instead of specifically mentioning one particular exception, I can simply mention exception. Anything is okay. Okay. So apart from the previous logic, I have included two lines here. One is creating a file. Okay. One is to write some content into a file. I have included one logic here. Okay. Now here, OPW, here see here. There is something called println. Okay, so here there is some logic called println. Here we are going to print some content over here. When I say opw.println means it is going to print some content to the text file here. Okay, basically here let me do one thing. This we are writing it, right? Let me capture into variable here. First of all, I'm capturing into a variable. Variable name is stText, okay, and then I'm printing it. Okay, so this loop is going to be repeat for the number of items that we have. So it is going to be printed into a text file. See here, opw dot. There is something called flush. Flush is something like save. It saves the file. Okay, closes the file. Okay, simple. So flush means it is saves the file. Dot close means it closes the file. When I say println, it basically writes the content to a file. Okay, basically when I say println means basically it should write the content in each line. Okay, whenever we use println, for each time it should write any new line, but as of now in this Windows 7, Windows is not doing it. Okay, actually this println is purely based on the operating system. In Windows 7, this is not working properly. Okay, in Windows 7 it is not working properly. Okay, when I say println, basically expectation is it should write the content into a new line here. It is not doing it. First of all, let me execute this. We'll come back to that. Okay. Now see here, I'm taking JNU test. Come on. Now see here, it has to search for something in the eBay. Then it has to print on the console, as well as it has to write into a text file. Okay. Why? What is the problem? Let me remove this. I don't see any syntax errors. This is my error. Yep. Yeah, we'll try to execute this. This class not from selected project. Whatever. This one only, right? It's okay. Let me do one thing. Let me take a brand new class here. Let me say write to a notepad. Okay. I took a separate class. Okay, now let me copy this method. Over here. Driver. Oh, browser. Okay. Now we'll try to execute from here. Yep. Sometimes happens. Sometimes even now it may not properly execute. You have to close the Eclipse and you have to open it back. Okay. Sometimes it will throw some unknown errors. In that case, close the Eclipse and open the Eclipse. Now it has to open a browser. Come on. Yep, yep, now it has opened a browser. Now it is searching. Now if you observe in the background, it is printing. If you observe in the background in the Eclipse, it is printing the values on the console. Okay, I think it is done. Yep. Now if you go here, you can find something like EV prices. Okay, now if you open this, yep, great. See, everyone observe here, it is printing here all this content. Basically, what sometimes what is happening, it is not printing in different lines. When we say println, when we see println here, sometimes here it is not printing line by line here. In that case, if it is not printing line by line, here we have to use slash r slash n. Okay, if it is not printing the values line by line, you have to use this. Of course, here now it is working perfectly. Okay, so it has just captured all the values and it is written in a notepad here. Okay, so here actually our main thing is how to write a values in the notepad. Okay, this is the core logic. Okay, now see, I am just keeping this this logic in our imp logic. Okay, this is the main logic for writing a content into a notepad here. Okay, so write content into a notepad. Okay, fine. Now let me move to next topic here. Clicking on menus, it's like handling menu items. Okay, now see here, it is something like this. Here if you go to ab.com here, let me take a new class. Handling menus, I took a new class here, and this is one of the frequent thing that we may come across. Okay, it's like handling menus means I'm not sure, someone was asking in our one of our friend, not sure, I did not remember the name, frequently one of the question like how to handle a link drop downs. Actually, that is not link drop downs, that is like we call menus. Okay, menus in the sense, see here, when you keep your mouse here, okay, when you keep your cursor on this particular item, it is showing some sort of links, right? Okay, so this, if you want to handle this kind of logic, if you want to write a logic for this, so if you keep your cursor on this electronics, it is showing some set of values here. Okay, now if I want to click on this cell phone and accessories, or if you keep your cursor on this fashion, okay, say I want to click on this kids and baby, or if I want to do this, if I want to click on this, okay, our normal logic will not work out. Okay, the normal way, whatever the way that we are so far we are writing, that will not work out here. First of all, what we have to do here, we have to make sure that our cursor should reach our unspecular fashion. Okay, first of all, it should reach, our cursor should be placed on this. Technically, we call it as a mouse over. Here, now let me take sheet, let me say special cases. Handling menus. Okay, first of all here we have to, handling menus means most of the cases it will be like this. First we have to do a mouse over. When we do a mouse over, it is going to show list of options here. Okay, in the list of options we have to select it. So technically mouse, we call it as mouse or hover. Mouse hover or mouse over. Some people used to say mouse over or mouse hover. Okay, we have to do mouse over on the, let me say on the menu, let me call it as a menu. Okay, these are the menus. Okay, so do the mouse over on the menu. Then click on the menu item. It means when you do mouse over and then select the just select the whatever the item that you want to do, whatever the item that you want to select here. Okay. So here let me go with fashion and let me select this kids and baby. Okay. So let us try to write a logic for this. So let me create a method here, public eBay menu. Now here browser. So here, first of all, we are opening the browser. And we are opening the URL. Okay. Then, see here. Now, if you want to do a mouse over, if you want to do a mouse over on this fashion, okay. So, first of all, we have to create an instance, something called actions. There is a class called action that will help you to do a mouse over. See here, action, let me say oact is the name of the object. Again, I'm creating the instance, everyone up here, I'm creating an instance. For this instance, I am passing a parameter here. Everyone up there, I am creating an instance. This is how we create an instance, right? Now for this instance, I am passing a parameter which is nothing but this instance, this browser instance. Okay. So here, and here import the, this one. Everyone up there, if you all up there here, this action class, action is a class which is available in different Java, it seems it is available in different Java packages here. Say it is available in something like some Calm, Opera. It seems it is there in Opera browser and some AWT. AWT means basically it is some set of classes which will help you to write the desktop based applications. Okay, basically it is related to development. It will help you to develop the desktop based applications. Seeing here XML. Now if you see here org.openqa selenium.interactions, so this action is related to our Selenium. Okay, so just select the Selenium here. Okay, now here I created the instance. Okay, I have created the instance and which is related to Selenium. It is not coming here. What happened? Created correctly, right? Let's write n one more time. Action oact new action. Let me write like this. And here we have to pause this instance only. It is showing like this. Let me see. Oact dot What is happening? Give me a minute, let me close this Eclipse. Why is it taking this much time? Give me a minute. Let it open. Yep. See here, no, actually currently we are discussing this topic. Let the Eclipse open. Now flaw Abdri here. The next section, we'll see if we can discuss a part of now. See here, capturing screenshot, okay, scrolling down and handling alerts. Handling multiple windows, auto suggest. These are the some special cases. It means we will not use them regularly. Okay, these are like some peculiar cases. Sometimes they may come across. Sometimes we may need to write a logic for these things. Okay, that is the reason I said special cases. Okay, so we are going to discuss this, and even don't get scared when we go for those things. Even sometimes I used to forget about the logics over there, okay, because as I said, it's a very rare cases. Basically, to be frank, I most of the times I use only for the class. In my practical work, it's a very rare case I use, but it is important. Okay, it's not that I'm not saying that we will not use in real time. We will use them real time, but not infrequent. Okay. Okay, then now we'll see it in the next session. Handling menus we'll see in the next session. I'm not sure why it is starting over here. We'll see. Okay, shall I proceed with this capturing screenshot?
Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.